Hi guys, and welcome to my newest video tutorial. So in this tutorial I'm going to explain you how to do split molds out of the mold we've made in the previous tutorial. So it should be right here on this window. It's new technology, it's called OLED, and it displays transparent images and so on, so very cool stuff. No, just kidding, so just After Effects. So I'll be showing you how to do a split mold. So it's very simple, it just cuts the molds into halves and put them back together, and this will enable me to remove the parts that has some undercuts right here. So the plug that will be coming out of this mold I'll be using to do a two-part mold with high temperature resistance resins and so on, so I'll be able to test out some pre-preg carbon fiber. I'll even make a silicon vacuum bag, test out some new fibers like basalt, flex fiber. I'll do some mixtures of carbon fiber with Kevlar, fiberglass and so on. So there will be a lot of tests coming out of this video tutorials from out of this subject. And if you're interested in it, just subscribe to my YouTube channel, get some updates, get notified about the newest tutorials I'm making. So this is about the tutorial, up to the tutorial, how you can do it. Okay, so this is a mold in two pieces. I'll just sand it with 220, go up in grit till 600, and I'll do it wet and dry, and that should give me a good finish to apply the release agent on. So, okay. Okay, so the last thing I'm going to do in the preparation is use this. It's the greaser. I'll just put it on a towel and just clean all the dust that are left inside the molds. So I'll do this now. Okay, so I have my improvised two-part mold, so it was just cut in two halves. Now I'm going to put them back together. I'm going to use some duct tape, very popular for simple use and so on, so very practical. And I'll just assemble them together again, so at the end I just can remove the two parts of the mold to release the parts that is cast on the inside. Okay, so I have my two molds over here. They're both closed now. Next thing I'm going to do is apply a release agent on it. This is from a Belgian company. You can see it here. I'll just have to apply two or three coats and wait 15 minutes in between, and you spray from a distance of around 20 to 30 centimeters from the mold. So this is what I'm going to do now. Okay, so I'm ready to go now. Everything is prepared, so I'll just do a quick overview. So here I have fiberglass, 30 grams square meter, just for the finish. Then I have some heavy fiberglass 450. So all of this is going inside of the mold. Then I have my brush I'll be using. This is polyester resin. I'll have to add MAC hardener. So it's 3% you have to add. So if this is 300, I did 300 and 200. I'll see if I need it or not. So this is 300, I add 3%, so it's 9 grams I have to add here. Then very important, safety. So I have my gloves, I have my mask, and my window is open just to have some ventilation and so on. So here is the camera I'll be using. So I'll be shooting The entire process will be around 40-45 minutes, I think, and I'll show you fast forwards how everything goes. So I'm going to get prepared and I'll show you how to do it. Okay, so I just finished laminating. Now while it's in a tacky state, I can use a Stanley knife and just cut off the excess while it's still soft, like it's not fully hardened. It will be easier to cut it off now and just don't have to trim it afterwards. So I'll do this now and then I'll let it cure for a couple of hours and then I'm ready to demold it. Okay, so the part just cured for a couple of hours and now I'm ready to demold the parts. So I'll remove the tape first. It should be quite easy to do. Except with my gloves are causing some problems. Thanks for watching. You can check the other parts by clicking on the video on top of the screen. And in the next video, I'll show you how to set everything up before laminating. If you like what I'm doing and want to see some more, have a look at my Facebook page and give it a like. And if you really like my videos, please subscribe for more updates on my following projects. And don't forget to like or comment for some feedback or questions. So up to the next video. Bye.